in class 9 biology we will see different questions related with the pollination and fertilization. We already studied the mature pollen grain structure and the ovule structure and the germination of pollen grain and also fertilization. We already studied this. Today you will see picture also I am giving. So here we will see the different differences between the self pollination and cross pollination. There is external agent is not required. Flowers must be bisexual, anther and carpel mature at the same time. Preserve the parental characteristics and pollen grains is produced in less quantities. Whereas in case of cross pollination, external agent is required. Flowers may be unisexual or bisexual, anther or carpel mature at a different time. Do not preserve the parental characters and pollen grains are produced in large quantity. Whereas in case of pollination fertilization, you will see a transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma of the flower, whereas fertilization fusion of male and female gametes with the eggs, that is the male gamete with the egg nucleus. Pollinating agents are needed, whereas in case of pollination and fertilization, no agents are needed. It occurs on the stigma of the flower, pollination, and it occurs on the ovules of the flower. It leads to fertilization and it leads to the formation of fruits and seeds. Harcogamy heterostyly, that mechanical barrier is present to prevent the pollen to reach the stigma of the same flower, that is pansy. Whereas in case of heterostyly, no mechanical barrier is present, instead of stigma and anther mature at the different time, that is oxalis. Now we will see another question, that is the what are the changes takes place in the ovary during fertilization. The pollen tube reaches the embryo sac through the micropyle. One of the male gametes fuses with the egg cell to form the zygote, and other male gamete fuses with the polar nuclei, forming the endosperm nucleus. The synergid and antipodal cells disintegrate. Another question sometimes there, that is explain the pollination of sweet pea. That pollination in sweet pea brought by the bees. The bees attracted by the color scent petal and land the wing petal. When it tries to get the nectar, the wing and the keel petal are depressed, and the stamen and stigma get in touch with the underside of the bee. If any pollen of their body is get transferred into the stigma, and new pollen gains stick onto its body, when it actually visit another pea flower, it will transfer these pollens into that stigma of the flower. So now we'll move on to the another question, that how does dichogamy helps in the cross pollination. The dichogamy means maturing of anther and stigma at a different time. In some plants such as salvia, anthers mature earlier than the stigmas, that is called the protonotary. In people, stigma matures earlier and then anther is known as protogyny. So actually by this way actually it help in cross pollination. So today up to that.